Hello, everyone. My name is Stefan Chandler Garcia, and I'm a developer advocate here at Salesforce. I wanted to create this quick take to follow up with my last video around using custom events to communicate between components and talk more about how we can take the detail and value from those custom events and pass data into our components and then render it within the UI. And in this case, I want to take those components and create a little to-do list where we can send data from one component and pass the items over to another and just put them into a list. So let's check out how we can do that. So in our previous video, we created a publisher and a subscriber component. The publisher, which fires a custom event that's then received by the subscriber component. To take this to the next level, I want us to take these two components and just create a simple to-do list that sends items from the publisher over to the subscriber. Now to do this, let's go ahead and first go into our publisher's HTML file and add a lightning input component into the component for us to capture that item. We're just going to give it a simple label and name, and then make sure that we use an onChange handler to capture the values and send that event to our JavaScript file. In our HTML, we already declared the handle change method, so let's go ahead and create that in our JavaScript and just pass in an event. We then want to add a property for storing the value of that input field. We're then going to take this.value and we're going to assign it to event.target.value. That way, we're taking the value from the input field and passing it into the value property within our JavaScript file. The next thing we want to do is go ahead and go into our custom event and remove that hard-coded string of value that we've had assigned to the event, and let's replace it with this.value. That way, we're taking the value from that input field, and when we click the publish button, we're actually going to send the field value from that lightning input field inside of our custom event. So let's go ahead and test this out in Salesforce. I'm going to type in a message into the input field and just click publish. And there you can see our message that we've typed in the input has been received by the component. And as we update that value, you will see that the value changes when we publish, and that new value is then received by the component. So let's take a look at how we can collate those values together and create our to-do list within our subscriber as it receives events from the publisher. The first thing we want to do is go into our subscriber.js file and add in a property for the item list. We'll go ahead and instantiate this as an array. This will allow us to push an item into it. As it's been instantiated, we must use the track decorator in our LWC, and we can go ahead and import that. And then just add the @track decorator to our item list property. Then in our handle message method, we're going to go ahead and remove that alert. And then we can go ahead and take our item list property, .push, and then push in that detail value. And that adds that into the array as an item. Now, the last thing we want to do in our JavaScript file is enable the component to conditionally show the list once data has been populated. Now, because an array is never null, what we need to do is check the array using a getter to identify whether or not there are items in the list. And if so, it will return true, and if not, it will return false, conditionally showing our element. So in our subscriber's HTML file, we're going to start out by creating a list class here and just use a class from the design system to make it nice and pretty. And this is where we're going to be putting those to-do items for the user to check off. Now we're going to use a template for each to iterate over those list items that we have in our JavaScript. And then for each item, we're just going to set a property of item so that we can pass that value in and then set the index as I. Now that we've got our iterator there, let's go ahead and add in a list item, and we're going to set the key to that index value as it's looping through those items. And then inside of our list item, we're going to use a lightning input field with a type of checkbox so that we get a proper checkbox there for the user to tick off. We're just going to set the name as the item, and then the label again, we're going to pass through that item's value there. Now, as I said, we don't always want to be showing the list. If there are no items in the list, we don't want to show them. So we're going to use that getter that we wrote earlier and just say template if true, and then add in our show item list here and close that template, and then take our for each of our list and pass it inside of that template if true. We're then going to again use a template if false to conditionally render based on that show item list getter as well, so that if there is no data within that array, we're going to show just a little text field. In this case, let's go ahead and put in a paragraph tag, add in a class to center our text, and just say, in this case, listening. So the component's listening for that event, and it's not yet received it. And pretty much this component will show us our list, and if there's no data in the list, just show us that listening tag. And that's really all we need to do. So let's go ahead and go into Salesforce and check out the components. So let's go ahead and type in an item into our lightning input and press publish. And here you go. We can see our item has been added to the list. And as we continue to add more items, it's sending the item value in that custom event over to the subscriber and adding them to the list. So just like that, we can publish data from our components using custom events and receive them in other components that have event listeners that are listening to those events as they occur. So just as I said in my first video, this is just one of a few ways that you can send messages from one component to another. Now, while custom events are easy and quick to get started with, as I said, please make sure that the data that you're sending isn't sensitive in the events, because anywhere that has access to the window within your browser can add an event listener and listen to those events as they happen. A great example of that is in Chrome extensions that exist within your browser. If you're using Chrome, they have access to that window and can listen to events as they're received. But otherwise, it's a great way of sending notifications from components to components. So if you have any more questions or feedback around this quick take, please go ahead and contact me on stefan.garcia@salesforce.com or follow me on Twitter at stefanwcg. If you have any ideas for other quick takes you'd like to see or more information, we'd love to hear your feedback. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video on using custom events to create a to-do list with Lightning Web Components. Be sure to like this video, subscribe to the Salesforce Developers YouTube channel, and click the bell so that you can get notified each time that we post a new video.